Ladies and gentlemen, it's Toy Tuesday.
Squad-a-la!
Steve, I thought you were in Virginia. Well, yes, by the time this video gets up on YouTube, I will in fact be in Virginia. Fortunately, I am smart enough to have recorded this Toy Tuesday, the Saturday before Tuesday actually happened, so I thought ahead.
Pretty sneaky, sis.
So today, I decided to go through my bobblehead collection. Really, there's not a whole lot I could say. I just like them, and I want to brag about them. I'm from Michigan, and I prefer Michigan State over U of M. Personal reasons. But they're good. And so my dad got me a bobblehead one year. Christmas. It's good stuff. This is Steve Eiserman, the legendary captain of the Red Wings. Gone now, retired, but he'll never be forgotten. My favorite Red Wing player when I was a child, back when the Red Wings won... they won Stanley Cups like it was a bodily function. When I received this bobblehead, Sully, Monsters Incorporated, Monsters, Inc. was my favorite movie ever made, and so my sisters are like, yeah, I'll get them this bobblehead, it was cool. Okay, this is a Frosty the Snowman bobblehead. Now, here's the thing. You know how on Black Fridays, really early in the mornings, they would sometimes just give out stuff, like, for free? Well, I had to wait outside of a store called Mervyn's, if any of you even remember that store. It's long gone now. But I got up at, like, 5 and waited outside in the frigid cold with my dad and my brother and got this bobblehead completely free because I'm a Black Friday devotee. And right below it is the Certificate of Authenticity. Which really, like, no one's gonna buy it or, like, even question that it's authentic, but it makes me feel like I've got this awesome collector's item. Yes, then you got your Spider-Man. I am the biggest Spider-Man fan, guys. You really have no idea. So when it came time for me to buy this, I think I bought this in, like, Ohio. Like, at a gas station. But whatever, it's cool. If you don't recognize this mug, you don't read comics a whole lot. This is Jughead Jones from Archie Comics. As a kid, I was huge into Archie Comics, so that's, and Jughead was always my favorite because he ate a lot and he had a hat and he was sweet and he was lazy. Kind of like me. There are no gangsters in Chicago, says Al Capone. Bobblehead. Got it from Chicago. Now the thing is, I've never been to Chicago. I actually picked this up at a Chicago airport because I had to drop my sister off there. So I've never actually been to Chicago, but I've been to an airport. So I guess that's enough. This dude's a pirate. And I bought him in Hilton Head Island, South Carolina. One of the best places in the world. If you've never been, I highly suggest it. He's awesome, and he's made of wood. But he's a pirate, so no one questions him. In case you haven't guessed by now, I have this weird thing about pirates. They're just freaking incredible, and I want to be a pirate when I grow up. No lie. Alright, well, I bought this back in The Office's heyday, at the end of season 2, or beginning of season 3. And what I like about it is, remember back when I was talking about this thing right here, this little Star Trek thingamabobber? And I'm all like, hey, this could be a movie prop. Well, this is essentially a TV prop, because Dwight has one of these on his desk. And so I couldn't pass up the opportunity to have one, because that's just the kind of guy I am. You might recognize this little bird from the Peanuts comics. His name's Woodstock, and I love this bird. I love this bird more than Snoopy, more than Charlie Brown, more than Linus. I don't know what it is about Woodstock. I don't even know if it's a boy, or a girl, or an it, or a robot, or a zombie. I don't even care. I love it. I wouldn't even be able to explain it. It's just, I love it so much. Go Woodstock, man. Peace and love. Iron Man bobblehead, really cheap, plastic, bought it at Walmart when the movie came out because it was chock full of all sorts of merchandise, and I'm all like, hey, I like bobbleheads, so I'll pick this bad boy up. I love it. This is one of my favorites, and I have to just zoom in on the awesomeness of this bobblehead. Do you see it? Like, there's this Joker card he's standing on, and like his coat, and his crazy hair, and I love it. One of the best performances ever. Now, if only I could find a movie Rorschach bobblehead, and I'd just be complete. This is Marvin the Martian. He's from Looney Tunes, obviously. You're like, Steve, I know all this. Why are you giving me a tour of your freaking bobblehead collection? Because I feel like you leave me alone. I picked this guy up at an antique store. He was on sale for like $3, marked down from 15. I know, ridiculous, right? But he bobbles amazingly. Look at that. As opposed to some people, like Jughead doesn't bobble at all. But look at him go. I want to put him on my dashboard, but I can't because he's like really breakable. So Chewbacca, little known fact about him, he's my favorite Star Wars character ever. And I would not be able to tell you why. It used to be C-3PO, then Boba Fett, then Yoda, but Chewbacca, he's just universally awesome. I don't even know. Funny thing about Chewbacca, come over here, across the room, I have a giant Chewbacca Pez dispenser. Like, what? Steve, what does he dispense? Well, obviously not candies. He dispenses something more awesome. He actually dispenses the little packs of candy. But that's not the best part. Watch this action. So. Thank you, Chewie. Can you honestly look me dead in the face, like right now, dead in the face, and go, Steve, that was so stupid and uncool. Because you're just jealous. You are so envious. You know you want one really bad. I know you do. You can see it in your eyes. I got this little bobbing, beagle thing. I just picked that up because I own a beagle. And I'm like, hey, beagle with a bobbing head. It's funny. Hey, do you want to see my dog? She's lazy and fat, but whatever. I'll show you my dog. Come on, let's go. Walking down my basement, going up my stairs. Gonna see my dog, cause she has lots of hairs. Hey, Cider. Cider. Hey, you. Yes, sir. She's shaped like an eggplant, but we deal. She's cute. Hey, you. Hey, you. She's old, so she's a little lazy these days, but we expect that from her. What is this? Just a really loud commercial. So yeah, that was a really kind of odd Toy Tuesday, but you know what? I'm leaving for Virginia on my birthday. I mean, come on, what is this? You can't even see my face anymore because it's so dark and mysterious. Guys, I've just been really hyper today, and I think it's because I slept until 1. So this has been a weird video. I'm not gonna lie, I've been acting weird, and a lot of weird things are weird and just weirdness. So, hopefully my videos will be more entertaining in Virginia and such. I don't know because I'm not there yet, technically, but I am there. It's this weird time paradox thing that I'm now creating. Wow. I just blew my own mind. It's just crazy. I'm in Virginia, but I'm not in Virginia right now. Like, by the time you guys see this video, I will be in Virginia. But, so, like, technically, I am there right now. Because you're watching this now. So I'm in Virginia. But I'm not in Virginia. What am I talking about? So, yeah. This is awkward. You know what? So, hey, I will see you guys later. Or will I see you guys today? I don't even know. This whole time Virginia, Michigan thing has screwed me all over. Whatever. I'll see you soon.